guys, the ministry in person of the Holy Spirit, probably the most understood, or use the word cloudy, of the three in the Trinity, God the Father, Jesus the Christ, the Holy Spirit, but the most powerful force or person or essence on the earth today is the person of the Holy Spirit. The same way you have a relationship with God the Son, you can commune but with Jesus by the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the presence of the Lord that got Jesus left on the earth when he ascended. The disciples said, "You can't go." He said, "Unless I go, he can't come." And when he came in Acts chapter 2 and breathed on the church, tongues of fire, the Holy Spirit fire, I want to pray for you in about 3 minutes. The presence of the Holy Spirit, the person to come through the screen, there's no distance. Come on, guys, God can move myriads of different ways. The Lord can speak myriads of different ways. Of course, we always want to see it and be backed up with scripture. Now, before I continue, it'd be an honor. Please subscribe if you're new. If you need prayer for anything in the comment section, prayer requests, needs are always welcome. People will also be praying for you in the comment section that sort of follow the ministry and the channel. I'm live Mondays, 9 p.m. You're welcome to come on the chat live. We'll pray for you live as we're praying for you. Hundreds will be agreeing with me in prayer. We'll break through. Hallelujah. Now I want to read some scripture. The book of John chapter 14. I will pray. Jesus said, I will pray and he will give you another helper. Parakletos, the Holy Spirit, that he may abide with you forever. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him nor knows him. For he will dwell with you and will be in you. The Holy Spirit, if you're born again, washed in the blood, is dwelling with you. And he is also in you if you've invited him to dwell in you, the same way you invited Christ. Jesus said, if you ask for the Holy Spirit, all you're going to get is the Holy Spirit. Ask the Holy Spirit. Say, Holy Spirit, come, I invite you to come fill me. Come dwell in me. And then there is a second infilling, you would say, not the baptism of, but the baptism in, the manifestation of tongues, the tongues of fire. It's a gift in the Bible. In Corinthians, there's different gifts that the Holy Spirit distributes as he feels fit. Every believer has the ability to have the gift of speaking in tongues. You have to release it by faith. Excuse me. Cats all over the house. You get cat hair in your eye. It's crazy. John chapter 14, verse 26. But the helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you some things. No. He will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all things that I said to you. Isn't it amazing? We're going about our day. All of a sudden, we can think of a scripture or something the Lord did for us in times past. That's the Holy Spirit encouraging you. John 16:7. Nevertheless, I tell you, it's your advantage I go away, for if I do not go away, the helper will not come. But if I will depart, I will send him to you. Last scripture, John 16:13. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. He will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak. He will tell you things to come. Father, Holy Spirit, I'm asking you, in the name of Jesus, come touch people, fill people. Yes, Holy Ghost, someone invite the Holy Spirit into your life by faith. The same way, say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I invite you, Holy Spirit, to come dwell in me. I know you dwell on me. Come take residence, envelop me. And then ask for tongues of fire. Matthew 3:11 says, I indeed baptize you with water, John said, but he who is coming after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. You need the Holy Spirit and the fire of God. The fire of God begins to burn and create a passion for seeking the Lord, for commune, for fellowship, relationship, passion for ministry, for sharing the gospel, for sharing your faith. Everywhere you go, telling people about the love of God, the gospel message of the Christ. Come on, release it out of your belly. Life, rivers, comes rivers and life. The Bible says it'll be unfruitful to your mind, but by faith, release tongues. And then you need to exercise, once you have tongues or the gift of tongues, you, the same way you exercise a muscle, you have to exercise that gift. I pray in tongues in my mind all the time, even at the gym. I'll pray out loud in tongues, even at the gym, driving my car. We're praying the will of God when we pray in tongues. Sometimes we don't understand things. We don't see things the way we should or could. But when we pray in the Holy Ghost, when we pray in tongues, we're praying a prayer language. First of all, the devil and demons can't, you know, it's like Morse code for the spiritual realm, the enemy. So get baptized in the Holy Ghost. The Lord bless you guys in Jesus' name.